Hey guys, welcome back to Spiral Knights, and this is Wigzop here, and we are gonna try and do something that's quite difficult today, and that is going to be soloing this last room on depth 27 with only a Venom Viler, and my pet as well. And the reason I'm doing this is because my former guild, actually, there was a guy in my former guild, which is Echo of Silence, by the way. I know some of you guys have been asking me that. My old guild was Echo of Silence, the one that you saw in my previous videos. But this guy in my old guild, Demonic Soth, or something like that is what his name is. I'm not even sure if he plays anymore. But he told me, and another friend of mine, that we were not true Echo of Silence members until we soloed depth 27, this last room, with only our Venom Viler. So that's what I'm going to be doing for you guys today, and I know you guys have been wanting me to get some videos out there, so that's what I'm trying to do now. It's difficult because I live with my roommate, and I can't really be recording while he's in here, so this is a weekend that I actually have to record, so hopefully I can get this out there for you guys. So we are gonna start this, and this is difficult, so no promises. I'm trying to do this without dying is the goal, but I may end up using some sparks to revive myself, but we'll see how well we can actually do. I haven't played this game in a while, so it's gonna be interesting. Here we go. Alright, let's try and take out this troll first. Gosh, get lag spikes already. Recording. Now I have done this once before. I actually have the video of me doing this on my old computer, and I was gonna record it, or I was gonna upload it, but I never got to it before I got to college, and so now I'm stuck kind of doing it again because my video is on my old computer, and my old computer's at home, so I can't exactly get that video very easily. So this is what I'm trying to do here. Oh gosh. And this will be slightly easier than I did it my first time, because now the pets are here, and my pet is going to be more than extremely useful. So I can get hearts from all the zombies when I finally finish off this Trojan. Hopefully this video doesn't take too terribly long. But as I mentioned earlier, I actually have a weekend here where I can record, where my roommate is actually back at home. So I am going to try and upload some other gameplay videos, actually, some other games that I like to play with some friends, and hopefully I'll be able to do that again tomorrow. I just recently uploaded one, so hopefully if you guys are interested, you'll check that out as well. And the trick to actually doing this is you lay a bomb here, and then you face the other way. He decided to be stubborn there. But see, I lay a bomb, and then I face this direction. It can be kind of tricky. But once you get it down, it's not too bad. It's the hardest part is for sure when there are two Trojans and all the zombies. A lot of times that's the part where I will actually get stuck. But like I said, again, I haven't played this game in a while, so who knows? I might be kind of rusty. And another thing I actually wanted to bring up is, I said Echo of Silence was my old guild, because I am no longer a part of that guild, and I have now joined a new guild called Nostalgia. It's a brand new guild. I actually think I might have been the first or second member. It was created, I don't know, maybe a week ago or so. We don't have many members right now, but I'm working with the guild master, and we are trying to get some new people in here. We're looking for specifically PvP players, PvP players, a lot of lockdown, that kind of stuff. But if you're interested, his name is Anar Bor. It's Anar-Bor. And if you're interested in possibly joining the guild, just send him some mail. Finally took off this drug. That took a while. Just send him some mail, and just saying, I finally got hit there. Saying why you or what you are looking for in a guild, and then also make sure put your tier on there, and then if you're comfortable enough, put your age as well, because we're kind of looking for friendly, possibly older. Older players, just because they seem to be a little bit more mature, and that's kind of what we're looking for. We're looking for a friendly, mature guild of just people that like to play games, you know. So if you are interested, definitely send him some mail. It's getting a little bit tricky now. What I should be doing here, this is what I should be doing. Hold on, bunch them all together. Boom! All those hearts, baby. Give me those hearts. Oh gosh, come on fire. Damn, I didn't actually know I could slip in between that fire. If you see that little space right there? I've done it twice now, I think. I didn't know I could do that originally, so maybe that'll be good. I gotta remember I have my pills, my three pills there, and my four as well. Alright. So question for you guys. I was just curious how many people actually do it, since I don't really PvE very much. I don't actually PvE or PvP very much. I kind of just get on and sit on the auction house for a little bit. But how many people actually use the shield bash? Where here, I'll actually show it here. Where they go like this. Like how many people? Ooh, hopefully I don't screw me. How many people actually use that? Because I personally don't find it very useful. I'm not sure if other people do or not. So leave a comment or something like. Do you guys use Shield Bash? And what do you think about it? Like, do you think they should somehow buff it so it's better and more useful, so more people use it, or do you think it's fine the way it is and you guys use it a lot? I don't know. Just I'm interested to hear what you guys have to say about that. So leave a comment. Also, if you guys want to like, the more likes I get, the more motivated I will be to make more videos. So if you want to see more gameplay, just more videos by me in general, leave a like, subscribe, stuff like that. You guys have already been doing great with all that stuff. I know I've been kind of lazy on getting these videos. Oh shit. Kill. Oh, jump! Yes! Alright, that was a little hairy. It's difficult because I'm trying to talk, I'm trying to think of what I'm trying to say, and then I'm also trying not to die. Alright, if I could get that off, that'd be great. Oh gosh, all those hearts. I hope they actually produce some hearts. And then also, actually what I'm also curious is, what pet do you think is the best? What pet do you find most useful? Oh, I'm stuck. I only have a high level in my Seraphinx, I believe it's called. It's my Seraphinx here. I think it's level 70 or something, 60 or something. Somewhere around there. Ooh, I could really use that remedy. I also have the fire one? I'm not sure. Because I haven't played in a while. I can't remember all this stuff. I also have the fire one. I don't have the dark wraith, I believe it's called. I don't have that one. But I'm curious which one you guys think is the best, because obviously I've only really used one extensively, and I am kind of curious if I should try and get another pet to a higher level, which is so goddamn expensive. Right. So we're doing pretty well, actually. Had a few hairy spots here and there, but I'm overall pretty happy. Haven't died yet. I got only one kill left, which is a little bit questionable. Two Trojans. Oh shit, I forgot about the two Trojans spawn. Nope, never mind. That's not good enough for me. I want three Trojans to spawn. Oh, I'm so screwed. Alright, how am I gonna get out of this one? So, somehow, I'm going to have to try and... I think my only chance at this point, really, is to get some of these Trojans, like, off-screen, and then I believe that they will stop being so aggro on me. I think they will actually legitimately just, like, sit. I have no shield. I can't move. I'm screwed. No, don't switch weapons. I knew I was done for once I killed that last zombie in that Trojan spawn. I forgot that would happen. Gosh, it sucks. Alright, well, we're gonna see if we can finish this up with three Trojans and only using one spark of life, so we'll see what we can do here. Oh, what I should have used, my Seraphinx's best ability, the R, where it like shields me from, like, is it all damage? It's at least a lot of damage that it will shield me from. This is tricky, man. It's trying to concentrate on this fire. It's a good thing I have fire max. Ugh. I no longer have any pills. I used it? I guess I used it. No, I used it. I picked up fire bottles. Those are fucking useless. I'm trying to pick up this remedy, but I have so many other bottles here. I used to use it. Come on. There we go. See, it's shielding from all damage until that Trojan corner locks me. Oh, there it goes. The original intent, like I said, was to be able to do this without dying. And like I said, I do have a video. Okay, I do have a video of it where I technically didn't die because I lag spiked, and like I actually disconnected because my old internet was just crap on my house. So I actually disconnected. I had full health, absolutely full health, and I disconnected. So I just used CE to revive myself once I reconnected. Obviously I was dead, and so I really didn't like leap. Like, there was no difference in my health. I didn't have any advantage whatsoever from using CE to revive myself, and it was just like I hadn't died. So I counted that as not dying, because I thought that was completely not my fault. There's nothing I could do about it. I just disconnected. So I might actually post part of that video if I ever get it back and get it on this computer. Now I'm kind of narrowing down the zombies at least. So hopefully I can take out some of those trolls without dying again. Two sparks of life, two deaths. A little unhappy about that, but it's tough when you're against three Trojans just using a Venom Violet. How can I separate these guys? I'm just kind of hoping and praying right now when I'm playing these games. Usually I have a method to see, and then they hit each other around too. It's so difficult, so hard. Now I'm corner locked. Just have to take the fire damage. Damage choice. So. Pill. I just want to get the remedy. Thank you. I don't know what to do. This is just going to be a cat and mouse game, really. Kind of hope I get some hits. There we go. Those two, I kind of like stuck back there. So if I can just keep this guy over here. See, they're not really doing it. Oh, I did. Yeah, no, I just stayed there. Oh no. Oh gosh, dang. So hard. With three Trojans. With two Trojans, it's difficult enough, but I decided I wanted to go against three Trojans, I guess. It's really hoping for a little bit better result here. I might actually die again. If I could freeze one of them. What I'm gonna try to do here. This is gonna be difficult. Alright. I'm gonna try and freeze. Oh, yes, perfect. Okay. So now. Come here. Yeah, there you go. Alright. Make sure to. Oh, damn, they're still coming after me. I thought they would just kind of sit up there because I wasn't close enough to aggro them, but apparently that's not the case. dash. Bad thing is, I have no more zombies to give me health. So I'm kinda stuck at my 3% health until I die. Certainly could happen. Yes! Get it! No! See, I could get some damage on them, but they like hit each other around right after I lay my bomb. So it's so hard to like try and place it. Gosh. That kind of lag spiked on me. I'm done making excuses. Done using my revives. See, this is so much less impressive since I'm dying so much. It's really impressive when you can do this without dying. Like I said, maybe I'll post that video as well once I get it. But if anything, for my own ego, my own sake, to kind of prove that I'm not lying about actually completing this. Oh gosh. Come on. Come on, Pat. There you go. Thank you. Oh, it's stunned. There you go. Get him. See, this is kind of the method I try to do. See, there's three of them. It's so hard. Trying to watch all three of them. Almost got like two of them dead. Gonna try and get them to dash into that bomb. Didn't take damage for that? Come on, man. Come on, give me a break. Fire. I'm curious what my time is right now. This has got going on. Probably 20 minutes or so, even longer. Not sure what the upload number is for YouTube, so hopefully I won't have to cut it into two different parts, but maybe the case will almost die like that. Oh, I'm gonna die right here. Oh, pro! MLG! MLG! I love everyone uses that reference now, MLG, when they do something impressive. Come on, die! No! Not me! I'm at the Trojan! Oh, gosh. How many is that now? Like, four or five revives? That's way too many. Way too many. At least I'm getting some gameplay out here for you guys. If I actually did just a no-death run, it may take me, you know, maybe a week. I have no idea how long it would actually take me. So at least I will post this, even though I died so many times. But at least you guys will have something to watch. Now that we finally got some of the Trojans down, this is just cake. Just a cakewalk at this point. Yeah. Well, there it goes. Well, thanks for watching, guys. It's too bad I wasn't a little bit more successful than what I was. But I did what I could, and I hope you guys enjoyed. So please leave a like, subscribe, leave a comment. I don't have a gun. I can't get it. Oh, let's just use one of these. There we go. But yeah, leave a comment. Tell me what you think about this. Go check out my other video that I actually posted. It's of a Garry's Mod Hunger Games. So check that out. And tell me what you think of that. And then maybe I'll do some more of that stuff. Because I'm a little bit more motivated to play different games instead of just playing Spyro on the main screen. Or just playing just one particular game. It's a little bit easier to be motivated to upload videos when I'm playing different games. So let me know what you think. And thanks for watching. Bye-bye.